So good morning to everyone and welcome to the INNORIT webinar from the title, What are investors looking for? I'm Alberto Dara and I'm a project manager at Unismart, the foundation of the University of Padua. Our mission is essentially to promote the technology transfer and post-larum education, basically creating a bridge between the academia and the different companies and realities of the territory. Together with other partners of the European INNORIT project, we are building a platform with the aim to evaluate the technological potential of innovative startups and ideas, trying to facilitate the access to financial solutions. The evaluation system is basically based on the well-established Korean technology rating system, but help over 200,000 SMEs acquiring more than 75 billion euros. Today, with the help of Francesca Natali, we are going to explore what early stage investors look for in innovative companies and what are the related do's and don'ts. Francesca is a managing director of Meta Ventures, the financial company of Meta Group, managing in Italy, Poland, and Slovenia public-private co-investment risk capital funds. I would like to thank her for taking the time to share with us her experience. And now I'm glad to leave the floor to her. Thank you, Francesca, and good webinar to everyone.
Thank you. Good morning, everybody. And thanks, Alberto, for such a nice introduction. I'm very happy to be here with you. I mean, for the next 1 hour, I'm really keen to share my experience with you as an early stage investor. I've been working for the last, 20 years for the venture capital industry. And I've been involved quite a lot in investing and also supporting young, innovative, ambitious entrepreneurs. So please feel free to stop me at any moment when you like, because my goal today, it is really, to share what I have learned from the field and to provide you with tips and suggestions, recommendations that could help you in being successful or more successful in approaching and getting money from early stage investors. So let's start. Let me share my screen with you. It's always a magic moment to, yes, here it is. It's the first one. Okay, let's put in the full mode. Okay, so let's start. I would like, I'm always used to start when I talk with early stage companies and entrepreneurs, provide them with a suggestion and tips on how to approach successfully investor, in telling them that all the money is not the same. What does it mean? It means that there are a number of different types of sources for money, and you should be capable to choose the right source of capital. In order to decide which is the best type of money that you should approach, you should take into account different type of information and make an in-depth assessment. I would like to tell you which are the main differences between debt capital, and I'm sure that you are quite familiar with debt capital, with reference to the risk capital, which is the equity capital. Debt capital, it's a quite, traditional type of money. It's the money that you try to get when you buy, when you are in the process to buy a new apartment, a new house, rather than you want to buy a car. Debt capital, it is a money that must be repaid one shot or per installments, and you have to repay the money lenders, giving back the money plus the interest, which is the price you have to pay to the money providers. So it is money that must be repaid, and for obtaining such type of money, you should provide, in most of the cases, personal guarantees. It means that you have to prove to the money lenders that you have the capability to give back the money at a certain moment. On the other end, we have equity money, which is also called risk capital money, because if you compare to the debt capital, it is a money that must not be repaid. It is risk capital. So it is money that share the same risk beared by the entrepreneur. So if things go wrong, it is money that you shouldn't give back to the money providers. But of course, as a debt capital, you have to pay a price for obtaining such type of money. And the price you have to pay is giving up a certain percentage, a certain piece of your company. That's why we call money for paper, because it is a money that will go directly into the social capital of the company to support, to boost the company grow in exchange of a certain percentage of the company. So you as entrepreneur, you as a current shareholder should be open, should be available to give up some ownership of your company. It is money that doesn't require personal guarantees. That's why it's a money that should support the company which are innovative, which are fast growing companies, which are companies that typically do not have the capability to provide guarantees to bank lenders. Equity capital, how it works. As I said, it is a money, it's a very interesting money, because as I said, it is money that it is not, it shouldn't be repaid if things goes wrong. But it is also money that go directly into the social capital of your company. How it could happen? Current shareholder should launch a capital increase, but before launching a capital increase, current shareholder should establish what investor call the pre-money evaluation of the company, which is always something tough fixed, to be established, especially if you are a new, innovative, young company. What is the pre-money evaluation? It is the value of the company before the investment. How it is possible to fix such a price? There are different methodologies, comparables from the market, discounted cash flow, and other methodologies that venture capital investor are used to use to determine, to fix the price of your company. But at the end, to fix such a value, it is always a negotiation issue. So when both parties, current shareholder on one end and investor on the other, agree on the pre-money evaluation, it is possible for current shareholder to go to the notary and launch a capital increase. In such a way, the new investor can enter into the company, buying new shares and putting all the money he can to invest into the company. It is possible to invest €1 million into very small companies because investors are keen to buy. In most of the cases, a very small percentage of the social capital, and to put all the rest, I mean all the remaining money, as a quota premium contribution. All the money, I mean the entire tickets, will go, as I said, into the social capital and will be used to support the business plan that the investor has decided to financially support through the round of investment. Here you, I mean, on the slide, you can see an example on how it works. I mean, there are some assumptions about the pre-money, of course, and the ticket that the investor is keen to buy. I hope it is clear. If you have questions, there are always questions about pre-money, post-money, and I mean, please feel free to ask for clarification, because I mean, I understand that I mean, it is a relevant point if you are approaching an investor and maybe you are keen ask for more information or more details about it. So, as I said, between debt and equity capital, there are different types of money that you may get to support the growth of your companies. You may go for guarantees that sometimes are required when you look for debt. You may begin to go for subsidies, which is a nice type of money because it is money that it is not dilutive, and it is money that must not be repaid. There are also other funding sources like factoring, franchising, lease, leaseback, so on. So the money is different. Choose the right type of money that fits your situation. And remember, this is, I mean, the second tips that I would like to share with you. Raising money, especially going into the market looking for risk capital money, is time consuming and it costs a lot. So you should organize your funding campaign, trying to avoid you to go out of cash. It means that you should look for money when you have money in your pocket, when you are still in a when you are still cash flow positive, because you have higher chances to get the money you are looking for if you have money in your pocket. Your negotiation capability, your negotiation, let's say, appeal, it's much higher if you have money, if you are not running out of cash. Another consideration rather than an observation, for young innovative company, money, I'm used to say, it's crucial, it's the magic ingredient, and it's very tough to be reached, but it is not enough. especially when you are at the starting phase. So check together with the financial capability of your investor to check if she or he is keen to provide you with more non-financial services, with additional support, non-financial support such as business support, business mentoring. It's really very, very important. And sometimes it can make a very big differences between successful company and a company that will grow very, very slowly. Because the business support means that you may have on board someone that could help you in opening doors that you are not capable to open at the right moment. It is very important, it's sometimes even more important to have money in your bank account. So conclusion number one, it is all about to align interest and to fit expectation. This is the game that investor on one end and entrepreneurs looking for money need to do to play successfully in the arena of the fundraising process. Alignment of interests, which are different at the very beginning, but then, I mean, we'll need to find a nice alignment, and fitting expectation. Fitting expectation, as I will tell you later on, means to know the engagement rules of your money provider. Because if you know the engagement rules of your counterpart, you know how to fit in the most successful and effective way the expectation that your counterpart has. And then it means that you have higher chances to have the money you are looking for. I already said that there are different types of money, but also, I mean, if we stay on the equity side, also if we look at the equity value chain, we may say that there are different types of risk capital investors, I mean different type of equity, let's say money, that will go into different type of company according to the stage of company life cycle. Why, I mean, I didn't say before, why investors are keen, equity investor, risk capital investor are keen to bear such a higher risk, which is the risk not to have back any, not to have back the money they have invested. Why they are keen to play the game? They are keen to play the game of investing into the social capital of an early stage company because they look for a profit. This is the main, the ultimate goal of their of the game they play. So if we look at the slide on the screen, there are different equity provider. They are different according to the type of company you are. Gnoti Theaton, it's a Greek sentence, meaning that you should know who you are if you want to be, in our case, successful in reaching the money you are looking for. It means that you should know if you are a startup, if you are a scale up, or if you are a scaler, because according who you are, you should choose the right financial partner. Money is different. There are different type of money providers. As a consequence, you as entrepreneur, you as a company, should look for the right financial partner. Do not talk with stranger. Choose the right risk capital investor. And who are they? If you are an early stage company, you should look for early stage money providers. They are typically business angels. In most of the cases, they are organized in network or in club. And then we have also seed and venture capital funds. And those type of investors who are specialized or institutional investors are in most of the cases vertical investor, meaning that they have preferred sector in which they have to invest. What does it mean? It means that according to the business sector of your company, you have to look and investigate if the funds you are approaching is keen to investor in the business sector of your company. Again, do not waste your time in approaching investor who are not keen to invest in cleantech rather than in biotech. Look at their portfolio and check if your investment could fit the portfolio they already have in place. Business angels and venture capital funds, in many cases, are keen to co-invest together. They have similar engagement rules. Remember, the main difference between business angels and venture capital funds is related to the fact that business angels are investing their own money. Venture capital funds, like me, for example, we are not investing our own money. So it means that we have our investment strategy that we have negotiated with our investors. We have a deadline with specific reference to our investors, because our investor, the investor that give us the money to be invested in your company, at certain moment, they come to us asking when we will give them back the money they have invested in our funds. So there are documents that can be analyzed by you as entrepreneur, and you may check, I mean, and you may get a number of information from the venture capital funds you are trying to approach. So we have a deadline. It means that we as a fund, we have a timeline with reference to our investment, which is much stricter if we compare to business angels who, as I said, are investing their own money, and they are more flexible in with specific reference to time and sector they can support. Just to make a very long story short, I would like, I mean, to give you, I mean, few indications about who should be the perfect investor. For you, being a new, being an early stage company, of course, a nice investor is an investor that has, who has money, enough money for supporting you through additional round of investment. It's always nice to have on board shareholder, financial shareholder, who have the capability to put the money if the company needs. If we look at the COVID situation, I mean, a number of companies have been capable to survive through the COVID time because they had on board investor that had the capability to put additional money to help them to survive. So look for rich investor, investor that have money to invest you in good and bad times that could come. And it's always nice to have on board investors, venture capital funds, rather than business angels that have a vertical expertise in the target company field of work, because it means that they can support you also in the business management of your company. Raising risk capital money is not easy. It is it could be a long and time-consuming process, and only few company at the end are successful. Why? Because it is related, it is linked to the fact that risk capital investors are looking for a special type of companies. And who are they? Who are those entrepreneurs? Are entrepreneurs that could grow very fast in a very short period of time. Also thanks to the money that the capital investor, the risk capital investor is keen to inject into the company. That's why only few companies have the physical role to receive such type of money. So you as entrepreneur should make, an assessment if you have the capability to grow in such a fast way, if you receive the money from the risk capital investors. Why do we look for such type of company? Why do we look for such a fast growing plan? Because the game we play is the game to leave the company. We used to say that we invest to exit. Since the zero moment, since the moment we put our euros within your company, we dream the exit time, because this is the game. And if you remember before, I was telling you it is all about fitting expectation and alignment of interest. And to fit our expectation number one is to exit, is to leave from you, from the company we have put our money. So you should prove, you should convince us that you will allow the investor to leave the company profitable in a very short length of time. I'm used to say that risk capital investors are shareholders with a deadline. Why do we need to leave the company as soon as possible, having back, what we have invested plus? Because we have to give back the money to our investors, because they pay us if we bring them back the money they have invested in our fund. So if you want to fit, if you as entrepreneur, as a company, if you want to fit our expectation, and if you want to make us very happy and increasing at the end the chance of being successful in having money from us, you should convince us that you can lead the company to a great exit in a very short period of time. Any question in the chat? No? Okay. So let me tell you how we evaluate you, how we evaluate our target company. Being an early stage investor, it is impossible for us to make financial assessment, to make serious financial evaluation. That's why for us, the management team is really the most relevant asset, and we make a very in-depth assessment about the entrepreneurial team. We evaluate the commitment, we evaluate the entrepreneurial experience, professional background, and so on and so forth. What we want to see is the capability of the management team in front of us to execute the plan you are presenting us, because the execution is the crucial point of any business plan. So you must be very smart in convincing us that your team has the best capability to execute the plan you are presenting. Then we also evaluate other assets. And the other asset you may have together with the management team is, of course, the IP. If you have IP, or if you have the capability to protect in the future the product, the technology you are developing, you have to show and you have to demonstrate that you have a clear, crystal clear IP position, current or expected. Then we make also investigation about the market you are in, and the capability, which is again your capability to execute. And here, you have to prove that you are capable to enter and to scale very fast your target market. Last but not least, we will invest only if we see exit possibility. So be smart and show exit routes, because it will prove, it will show us that you know the game we are both playing. Technology in itself, it's never an issue for us. What does it mean? It means that we are not keen to invest into a technology breakthrough if the technology, if the product behind or the product or the service behind has not a proven, a nice market in front. Technology without a growing and a competitive market is not interesting for us. Okay, so keep in mind, because especially when we talk with the researcher, with professor within the university, working at university, they show us very promising patents, but without a sound and a proven, even if future application of the technology they are developing. So you should have an exploitation plan in front of you, because we will never invest in a technology if the technology has not, a market application. Just to go, to the final part of my speech, what I would like to outline once again that risk capital investor and entrepreneurs are playing, a game. They are seated at the same table, and they have their role. They have their own needs to be fulfilled. But at the end, if the deal is closed, if parties are capable to reach an agreement, it means that investor and risk capital investor and entrepreneurs will be on the same goal, sharing a journey, even if it is a journey with a deadline for a while. They share the same journey and they have to work together for common goals. And the common goals is to create value. It means to increase the value of the company. They have to work together. The entrepreneur should put his or her knowledge and capability and commitment and time dedication to boost and to support the company growth. The investor will put money and expertise, if it may be the case, in order to create value inside the company, in order to reach the magic moment, which is the exit time. So you as entrepreneur, remember that the exit time, the exit moment, is the moment you both should try to achieve. And for you entrepreneur, in most of the cases, it means that you should be open and available to sell the company. So this is something that should be very clear since the very beginning, because to capture the value that has been created through time, thanks to the money and the time dedication, is the exit moment. And the exit moment, it means, to reach a liquidity event. The liquidity event in 95% of the cases is to sell the company. So be ready to accept since to accept it since the very beginning and to work closely together with the investor to reach such a moment. You all will be rich if you are good in achieving a profitable exit. So it should be a nice moment for all the parties involved. Here in the slide, you may find some rules to live together for the time being, since the liquidity event, since the not since until the exit moment. Most of those engagement rules, which are detailed within the legal documents you have to negotiate and sign, refer to the exit exit moment, because once again investors, financial investors, need to protect themselves in order to be sure to reach, in any case, the liquidity event, to reach the exit. So you, entrepreneur, be ready to negotiate and accept such type of rules. Use expert lawyers. When I say expert lawyers, it means use an advisor that has expertise in such type of documents. There are different type of lawyers. I mean, I said that there are different type of money, but there are also different type of lawyers. So you should select the one who has the right knowledge to support you in shaping and in negotiating such type of rules, clauses, and documents. What's more, yes, few more tips before meeting an investor. Remember, investors want to have in front of them an entrepreneurial team. So you must be an entrepreneur and you must have a nice team behind you. What is a team? What is a core team? A core team is not one person, is not two person, it is at least three person. Because I mean, one person cannot be committed in playing successful different roles. So you need to have a core team around you. You need to have a business project, and a business project, it is not an invention, it is not a research project. That's why when you also design your business plan or a pitch deck, you should avoid to present your business idea as a research project, because a business idea, a business project, again, it is not a research project. And you should have a clear view of all the money you need to reach the exit moment. You shouldn't ask to the investor, and do not underestimate the money you may need. We prefer to invest a little more than less, because you should have all the money you need to grow in a very fast way. So you should make your homework, and you should have a clear view of the money you need. financially support the whole plan, even if you are asking me a certain percentage of all the money you need, I want to know how much money you need until the end. Remember,
Francesca,
yes.
We have a question from the floor. Yeah. So Justina asked us, thank you very much. Do venture funds diversify their investments? If let's say VC has already invested in a very similar company or technology as mine, do my chances of getting an investment lower?
No, it depends if it is exactly the same or if you work in a complementary field, because it is the opposite. We like very much to exploit synergies between among our portfolio companies. So if you know that the funds has already invested into a similar company, you may stress in your executive summary, in your pitch, which are the synergy for the funds to invest into your company. So sell as an opportunity. Okay. More question? No?
No, for the moment, no.
Okay, and again, which are the issue for us? I already told you, we want to know when we will have our money back. And we also want to have the capability to measure the opportunity versus risk we support. So you must be prepared before meet any investor. You have to exercise yourself, especially in delivering a smart and a brilliant pitch deck. Get ready for delivering the pitch, and remember, when you deliver your pitch, you shouldn't be capable to provide the investor with all the relevant information, but what is very important is you to leave an impression, because this is the reason why you are pitching in front of investors who are listening to thousands of pitch. You must impress your investors, because this is your chance to have a second meeting, a more organized one, when you will provide all the relevant scientific, technological information. So be ready to deliver a smart and appealing pitch. And last but not least, I already told you, do not talk with stranger. Choose your investor carefully and go for the right one. Why we do not invest? Okay, I will not tell you anymore about exit. We will never invest into a company where the management team is not fully committed and not trustable. We like very much, especially if we are a biotech rather than a medtech company, to invest into IPR. So again, show that you have an IPR in place. And sometimes we do not invest because our counterpart is not investor ready, is not keen to negotiate, is not keen to play the game we have to play. And so even if the deal, it could be, interesting for us, we will not invest. at the end, who are those brilliant and fast-growing entrepreneurs? Who are they? Facebook, of course, Microsoft, but we all know the stories about Facebook and Microsoft, and it's easy to say, okay, I would have invested into Microsoft rather than in Facebook, but there are other stories that could be successful. Stories meaning companies that could come also from not the Silicon Valley, but that could come from small villages like Greenbone, for example, which is a very promising so far company, which is in the process to scale, because we have just bought our first industrial site up to the north. But Greenbone comes from a very small place, very close to Bologna, in a very nice and promising environment, which is Faenza Research Center. When we decide to invest into Greenbone, the company was not there. Only a couple of very smart and fully committed person, one coming from academia and the other one coming from the industry world, were there with a nice patent. And we decide to invest at the very beginning. As I said, now the company is going through the clinical phase. We have bought our first pilot industrial site, and we are keen to reach an exit by the end of 2023. So it is possible to start and to grow and to receive also a number of round of investment, even if you are not in the Silicon Valley, but you should convince the investors that you have a great team and a very promising product in fitting a clear market need. And this is the case, as I said, of Greenbone. Which is developing an innovative bone implants, which is capable to regenerate and to get connected with your bones without a long and painful rehabilitation period. So we believe that Greenbone can be the type of company that could reach a nice and successful exit. And I think, yes, it is all.
We have another question from the floor. What is the reasonable percentage of equity to give up for VC investment?
So it is a tough question to be answered because it is linked to the moment the investor is putting the money. Early stage investors are not keen in most of the cases to buy the majority of your company. We are always keen to be minority shareholder, to leave to the founder the incentives to boost and to push the company grow. The right percentage, I would say that it is something between 15 up to 45, okay? It is a quite big range because we know that we as investor, we know that the company will go through additional round of investment. It means that if we as a seed investor are not capable to follow the round, meaning to join the next round of investment, we will go through a dilutive process. So we should make a balance between the company value, the money we are investing, and the total money that the company will need to reach the exit. So something between 15 and 45%.
Thank you. And we have another one from an anonymous person. I am a researcher thinking of founding a company based on my patent. I have considered creating a startup or a spin-off. Which one is more appealing for the investors?
A spin-off? Does it mean spin-off that you have university on board? Huh?
Yes. Yes.
Frankly speaking, we do not like to have university as a shareholder. Not because, I mean, we have something against university, because, for example, Greenbone, it has been set up within, let's say, a research center. We like very much, I mean, to have agreement with the university. We like to pay university for labs, for facility, and so on. Having university as a shareholder, it means to go through a quite tough decision making process. Okay, and so we prefer not to have the university as a shareholder, but having the university outside to support the company and to receive money from the company, even if it means to set up an agreement which is linked to royalties. Royalty means that the university will receive the value, a certain percentage of the value that will be distributed among shareholders at the exit moment.
Okay, thank you. That's all for now. If you have any other questions, we have a few minutes left.
Okay. Any curiosity?
I have a question for you, Francesca.
Please.
So let's say like there is like a startup which is like a couple of years old, maybe more, 3-4 years old, and who has experienced like a slow linear growth instead of like a rapid exponential growth. Mm-hmm. Would be interesting for investors too, or they're looking for like more dynamic business opportunities?
More dynamic business opportunity. I mean, the type of assessment that could be done if the linear growth is linked to the fact that the company has not been capable to have enough money to support, I mean, a fast growing growth. So the question is, if I receive a huge amount of money, am I capable to invest the money, all the money I'm receiving, and to grow in a very fast way? If the answer it is yes, you may go out in the market and try to convince investors that you are the right guy. But if the type of business you are doing, even if you receive millions of euros, cannot grow in such a fast way, no, do not go, do not try. You are wasting time.
Okay, thank you very much, Francesca. So I don't know, Elena, if there are other questions.
No, No, we don't have any other questions from the floor, so we can wrap up.
Okay, so thank you very much again, Francesca, for sharing your experience. Thank you all the attendees for participating in this webinar. I invite all of you, if you have any other questions, to write to alberto.dare@unismart.it. We will link you with Francesca, and we will try to answer your questions or curiosity, so offline. So you are very welcome to write via. And that's all. I wish you all of you a nice day, and see you. Bye-bye.